Hey class, I'm Mr Thornton, and I'm going to help you get that C in your GCSE. This lesson, cloning. Cloning a plant, this geranium for example, is pretty easy. All you need to do is make a cutting, chop part of it off. You might need to dip the end of this in some plant hormone, some rooting powder which contains auxin. And that will start the roots growing. You need to leave it in some water to allow the roots grow. And the cutting will grow into a plant which is genetically identical to your original plant. Its DNA is exactly the same. So it's really, really easy to clone plants. We can reproduce different species of plant that way really, really incredibly easily and have done throughout history. Cloning an animal, on the other hand, is considerably more difficult because you can't just chop a limb off an animal, stick it in some hormones and wait for the whole animal to grow again. Animals are much more complex. So the process for cloning an animal is a little bit more difficult. Let me run through that and I'll show you. Remember, the nucleus of every cell contains a complete copy of that organism's DNA. So the nucleus of this one animal cell contains all the DNA necessary to make a copy of this animal, a clone. We very carefully remove the nucleus from the animal cell, and then we're going to need an unfertilized egg cell, taken from a female of the same species of animal. We remove the nucleus of the unfertilized egg cell and discard that, and then we introduce the nucleus from the cell of the animal which we want to clone. The unfertilized egg cell now contains a complete copy of the DNA of the animal which we want to clone. A small electrical current is then applied, and this starts the egg cell dividing, just like a normally fertilized egg cell. And that egg cell will then steadily develop into an embryo and then a fetus, which is genetically identical to the animal we're trying to clone. The embryo is implanted in the uterus of a surrogate mother, and after the gestation period is over, the clone of the animal is born. This clone is, in genetic terms, an identical twin. Its DNA is exactly the same. But because it was born at a different time, from a different uterus, it can actually be a completely different age. Remember, any cell with a nucleus can potentially be cloned into an entire animal. Lots of species of animal have now been cloned in this way, which raises an obvious question. Could we use it to clone a human being? Well, in theory, yes. Welcome to Clone Club. However, there are strict regulations governing human cloning for ethical reasons. For example, it would be unethical to clone a human being just to use their organs for spare parts.
Ooh, I'm a person too, you know.
So for that reason, no more than a few human cells have ever been cloned.
Yeah!
I hope that video was helpful to you. If it was, click just here to watch a related video. If you click just here, then you can see all of my videos on all of the different topics that I've covered. If you click just here, you can download my Android app to help you with your revision. Or if you click just here, then you can subscribe to my channel and get updated every time I upload a new video. Don't forget to leave comments and likes below. Good luck in your GCSEs, and thanks very much for watching.